At the end of last month, NIO said it's shutting down production at one of its factories for 5 days due to the global semiconductor shortage. So what's the situation like right now when it comes to the supply, of chips on your end? What kind of buffer do you have?
It's true that since the first quarter of this year, the global automobile industry has encountered a shortage of semiconductors. We were also affected a little bit. The pressure will still be very high in quarter two when it comes to chip and battery supplies, thereby putting some pressure on our overall deliveries. But I believe things should get better in the second half of the year as we see chip manufacturers already responding to the demands of the automotive industry.
Your peers like Xiaopeng is said to be keen to develop its own in-house chips. Any plans from NIO to do the same?
We will do the necessary research and development according to the needs of technological development.
Would you be interested?
And NIO, we usually announce something only after we've managed to do it, so you have to give us time.
Now, NIO's gross margins have been increasing, I've noticed. I think for your Q4 2020, your gross margins reached 17%. Do you have any ideal level of margins, and how do you plan to achieve that?
We went from recording a gross loss in the first quarter of last year to a positive trajectory thereafter. So a growth margin of over 17% in quarter four was really good for us. The main driving force is that our sales volume is increasing. Our deliveries last year were more than twice those of 2019. Of course, we've also done a lot of internal management work to improve our efficiency and bring down costs. In general, I'd say our increase in gross profits exceeded our initial expectations. We've now reached a decent level. Tesla calculates its growth margins quite differently, but if you were to compare, our margins aren't actually that different.
So stronger volume is actually driving your higher margins right now.
Yeah.
Do you forecast these margins, gross margins, to continue increasing in the next few quarters?
We believe there's still room for our margins to improve, but don't expect to see a dramatic improvement like last year's.
When does NIO plan to break even?
It's still going to take some time for us to break even. NIO is only 6 years old after all, and it's less than 3 years since we started delivering our products. At the moment, we're still focusing on research and development for future technologies, such as autonomous driving, with the goal of having more models entering more markets. So we're still in the investment phase, which includes our infrastructure, such as charging stations.
What's going to be driving NIO's growth in the near and medium term?
If you look at our sales volume, it increased from 10,000 units in the first year to more than 20,000 in the second year, and over 40,000 units last year. In the first quarter of this year alone, we have sold 20,000 units. We now have three models, and our top 10 cities in China, when it comes to sales, accounted for about 60 to 70% of our entire sales volume. As such, we still have many more regions waiting for us to expand into. China's auto market is a huge one. Our sales volume last year was just 5% that of BMWs in the country, so we still have a lot of room to grow. We will continue to launch new models and enter the global market. So from a revenue growth perspective, the potential is huge.